अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन। व्हाट इज़ नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन? इट इज़ अ वर्ड बियॉन्ड वर्ड्स, मींस दिस वर्ड डजंट नीड वर्ड और वर्ड्स। सो व्हाट डज इट नीड देन? सो इट एड्स और इट इंक्लूड्स योर जेस्चर्स, योर बॉडी लैंग्वेज, योर बिहेवियर अबाउट सर्टन थिंग्स। व्हाट इज़ नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशंस? These are the messages expressed by non-linguistic means. Non-linguistic means without using any language. It includes silent behaviors, its environment, artifacts, and vocal intonation. It is a powerful mode of communication. Silent behaviors means sometimes we convey the meanings for being silent for some time. We used to behave according to the environment, like we know how to behave in a university and our behavior at home is totally different from that of university. So it is environment based. Artifacts includes your accessories, your dress codes, your bags, your shoes and everything related to it. And vocal intonations means your voice, high or low. And of course, it is a powerful mode of communication. But is non-verbal communication? According to the experts, a substantial portion of our communication is non-verbal. Yes. Do you agree with this? Every day we respond to thousands of non-verbal cues and behaviors, including postures, facial expression, eye gaze, gestures, and tone of voice. Is it so? Like student and teacher, if we are going to take the example of student and teacher, students know very well about the mood and behavior of the teacher. They can judge their teacher by the facial expression, by the behavior, their posture and eye gaze. Like either it is either the eye gaze is friendly or it is a strange one. So, and also the tone of voice. If the teacher is talking to you in a high tone, it means that is the teacher is aggressive or angry with you. And if it is humble or in a it is if the teacher is talking in a humble and calm voice, so it means teacher's mood is good. From our handshakes to our hairstyles, non-verbal details reveal who we are and impact how we relate to other people's. How, like, we do handshakes with our friends in a very we can say strong way. We give strong impression to them. Rather, we just be stranger, or we can say neutral to the people we don't know. And from handshakes to our hairstyles, like if you are happy, you will decorate yourself or you will maintain your hairstyles. And if you are not happy or not easy, then you don't bother about anything. So these are the non-verbal codes that reveal our personality in front of the people. What is the non-verbal communication? Scientific research on non-verbal communication and behavior began with the 1872. So the research on non-verbal communication was started in 1872 with the publication of Charles Darwin's The Expression of the Emotions in the Man, in Man and Animals. So it was a book by Charles Darwin's where they studied the expressions or impressions of human beings and animals. Since that time, abundant research has been conducted on the types of effects and expressions of unspoken communication and behavior. While these signals are often so subtle that we are not consciously aware of them, research has identified several different types of nonverbal communications. So a lot of research has been done on nonverbal behavior or nonverbal communication. In many cases, we communicate information in nonverbal ways by using groups of behaviors. For example, we might combine a frown with crossed arms and unblinking eye gaze to indicate disapproval. So how do we communicate? Like if we want to disagree with our friend or with a person and we are showing a frown on our forehead एंड वी आर क्रॉसिंग अवर आर्म्स एंड वी आर नॉट ब्लिंकिंग अवर आईज, इट मीन्स इट इज़ शोइंग डिसएग्रीमेंट विद द पर्सन. ओके, करेक्टरिस्टिक्स प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन. ऑब्जर्व दिस पिक्चर एंड मूड ऑफ डोनाल्ड ट्रंप इन दीज फाइव पिक्चर्स. वट डू यू परसीव? टेल मी इन डिटेल इन योर वॉइस मैसेजेस. ओके, ऑल बिहेवियर्स हैज कम्युनिकेटिव वैल्यूज बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट कम्युनिकेट. मे बी इंटेंशनल बट इट इज़ ऑफन अनकॉन्शियस. वी कैन नॉट कम्युनिकेट वट दे आर सेइंग. इट कैन बी इंटेंशनल, मे बी इंटेंशनल बट इट इज़ ऑफन अनकॉन्शियस. लाइक समटाइम्स वेन समवन इज आस्किंग अबाउट समथिंग, लाइक इफ आवर फ्रेंड इज आस्किंग डू यू हैव अ पेन, एंड वी इंस्टेड ऑफ रिप्लाइंग टू देम वी जस्ट नोड अवर हेड लाइक येस वी डू हैव. इंस्टेड ऑफ रिप्लाइंग विद द वर्ड्स वी टेल देम विद अ जेस्चर. दीज ऑल्दो वी आर ऑलवेज सेंडिंग मैसेजेस थ्रू अवर नॉन वर्बल्स, दीज मैसेजेस आरंट ऑलवेज रिसीव्ड. सो वी डू सेंड मैसेजेस थ्रू अवर नॉन वर्बल बिहेवियर बट समटाइम्स दीज मैसेजेस आर नॉट रिसीव्ड वेल, लाइक द अदर पर्सन डजेंट परसीव. समटाइम्स वेन यू वॉन्टेड टू टॉक टू योर फ्रेंड, टू योर टीचर, टू योर वन ऑफ द फैमिली मेम्बर्स, इन non-verbal communication like you are using signals, you are using gestures, and that person most often that person doesn't understand what you are trying to communicate. It mostly happens when your mother is trying to give you the signals in front of the guests. We especially pay attention to the non-verbals when they contradict verbal communication. So we pay attention to the non-verbal gestures only when they are contradicting our verbal communication. Okay, what is non-verbal communication in primarily relational? Okay, they are saying non-verbal communication is primarily relational. How? Responsiveness. It includes responsiveness, how communicates our interest in others. Communication, women are generally more responsive than men. So women are more responsive than men. People in lower positions tend to be better at reading non-verbals. So responsiveness is what? You are responding the other people using non-verbal communication. And it is considered that women are more responsive than men. And also they are indicating or they are showing a research on the point that lower power position people tend to be better at reading non-verbals. Okay, then comes liking. What is this? Positive or negative feeling about others. Like we can experience or we can exercise power, we can exercise touch, like it can be a violence, it can be abuse, and it also includes love as well. Space and silence. We are going to read this in detail in the next slide. Okay, a little more about the relational nature of non-verbals. Non-verbals are especially important for identity management. What is identity management? In defining our relationship, for example, level of intimacy. What is identity management in non-verbals? Like your students, your surrounding people, your family, they always know you, they always know you with your gestures. Like your mother tell to the guests or to your friends that my son reacts this way if I am not going to cook according to his choice. You know your friends with their behavior. So this is identity management, that you recognize people with their habits, with their gestures, with their postures, with their non-verbal communication or non-verbal signals. In defining our relationships, level of intimacy, so also it is going to show level of intimacy as well. For expressing emotions, we don't want to express, can't express or don't know we are feeling. How? Like non-verbal communications help us to give indication to the other people about our moods that we doesn't know how to use words. Like, if we are angry, even if we are not using words, the other person can easily judge from our gesture, from our body, that person is communicating something bad to us.